Hello students, in this lesson let us study about the windrows diagrams. So as discussed in the previous lesson, windrows diagrams are very important for deciding the runway orientation. So we'll dig deeper into how to draw these windrows diagrams in this particular lesson. So to get started with, as already discussed, for the airport, normally the average wind data of around 5 to 10 years will be corrected, and this will be represented in the form of graph or a chart, right? That diagram is called as the windrows. So the diagram is given the name windrows because that shape or the irregular pattern which is created will be visible in the form of a rows. Okay. So why is windrows diagram useful? For two important reasons. One is for the determination of the most suitable runway orientation, and the second one is for the estimating the runway capacity. Right, for these two reasons it is important. Now you consider this table. This is the typical wind data for an average of 5 years which is taken. It is assumed that the duration of the wind from one direction covers an angle of 25 degree as shown in this figure. See here. So 22.5 degree for one direction. If you want to take in one direction, you have to cover 22.5 degree. That will give you the wind in that particular direction, as you can see in this particular figure. Okay. So if you see the typical wind data, you have the wind direction, percentage of time or duration of wind. So if the speed of the wind was 6 to 25 km/h in this direction, this was the percentage of time in which it was available. Like that, in between 25 to 50 km/h, in between 50 to 80 km/h. Like this, a total is done in all the direction. This is what the total percentage of wind that is blowing in each direction. So in north, this much of total percentage is blowing, out of which this speed is of 4.6% and this speed is of 1.4% and this is of 1.01%. So like this, for 5 to 10 years the data will be collected, and as told, if you are taking in north direction, it is covering what? Your 22.5 degree to the, half to the right of north and half to the left of north. That entire will come under the north division, right? So once you understood this, we can plot the windrows diagrams in two ways. Okay, so the first one is, let us call this as type 1. In this type, it will be showing direction and duration of wind. So what is it showing? Direction and duration. So in the type 1, two things, right? Similarly, in the type 2, it will be showing directions, duration and intensity of wind. So let us now in detail discuss about the type 1 windrows diagram and type 2 windrows diagram. The type 2 windrows diagram is of the most importance, but we'll have to study both. So to get started with the type 1, what we will do here is the radial lines will indicate the wind direction, and each circle will represent the duration of the wind at a certain scale. Understood? So these lines will indicate what? Wind direction. Okay. And let me write radial lines. And these circles which are there, this will indicate the duration of wind. Duration of wind. So we have seen that in the first, we will take care of direction and duration. Right. So this is your direction and this is your duration. So from the wind data of this table 4.1, the total percentage of wind blowing in north direction, see how much is it? In north direction, the total percentage is 6.10. And accordingly, this point is marked along the north direction. See, I will show you here. So along north direction, see here, 6.1. Like that, in all directions, the total you have to plot. Say, if we see NNW, check in the table for NNW, how much is it? 4.15. Like that, you have to go on plotting for every direction and then connect it. Okay. And then connect it by the straight lines. So the best direction of the runway is indicated along the direction of the longest line on the Windrose diagram. So whichever you will get the longest line, that should be the orientation of your runway. If you observe here in this diagram, WNW, west northwest and east southeast is the direction of the longest line in this Windrose diagram. So this should be the orientation of runway. We can tell it as this is the best suited according to the type 1 method, where we are considering the wind direction and wind duration. So this type of Windrose will not consider the effect of crosswind component. That is the major disadvantage, right? So disadvantage is what? It will not consider the effect of crosswind component. As we have already seen, that crosswind component is also one of the important factor which will help you in deciding the runway orientation, right? So because this is not taken into consideration, this type 1 of the drawing of Windrose diagram is not so much best suited. Let us go to the type 2. So in type 2, what all we will consider? We will consider direction, duration, as well as intensity, right? Direction, duration and intensity. Now I will show you from the table, right? It can be seen that the percentage of time during which the wind velocity is less than 6 km/h works out to be, so between 6 to 25 is this much, between 25 to 50 it is this much, right? Between 50 to 80 it is this much. Now this total will give you this, right? So less than 6 km/h, how much will be there? So total 100 minus this whatever is there will give you 12. Okay, so 12% of the time the wind is less than 6 km/h. Okay, so this is normally called as calm period. Okay, so what is this called as? This is called as calm period. Okay, and it will not influence the operation of either landing or takeoff because the wind is of very low velocity. So thus what we can do, the wind velocity below 6 km/h has no effect on fixing the orientation of the runway. That is what we can decide. Now moving on to the construction, how do we construct this type 2 Windrose diagram is? So let's first discuss it in point by point manner so that it will be easy for us to understand. I will write it as procedure for drawing the Windrose diagram according to type. So normally, what are these concentric circles with radius corresponding to 6, 25, 50 and 80 km/h? We have to draw to the scale. Why? Because in the table, if you have observed, we have taken between 6 to 25, right? 6 to 25, 25 to 50 and 50 to 80. We have to draw it to a particular scale. Very important, right? After we draw that, so let me write first is what? Concentric circles of 6, 25, 50 and 80 km/h. So what will these represent? This will represent the wind velocity. Next, secondly, starting with the center of the concentric circle. So from here, say this is the center of the concentric circle. Let me call that as O. So from here, we have to draw 16 radial lines or directions up to your outer circle. See, if you observe, these are the 16 directions. North, south, east, west are 4. So in between north and east, there will be northeast, north, northeast and east, northeast. So near to east, near to north, like that. So like that, total 16 directions we have to mark. Okay. So these will be in the form of cardinal directions, right? And we have to mark all these namings. Then what we have to do? The recorded duration of wind and expressed as percentage are shown for each radial direction in the sector pertaining to that direction. Okay, that means what? Now we have seen that between 6 to 25 km/h in the north direction, we have 4.6, and between 25 to 50, we have 1.4, and between 50 to 80, we have 0.1. So if you want to check, just have a quick look on the table. So 4.6, 1.4 and 0.1. So likewise, in all the directions, we need to mark these numbers. That is what is our next step. Okay. So recorded duration of winds, this should be expressed in percentage for each cardial direction. So it may be noted that the cardial direction is central to its sector. So taking the wind data from north, the duration of 625, 2550, 5080 kmph wind velocities are shown in three pertaining parts of the north sector as 4.6, 1.4 and 0.5 percentage. Similarly, for north-northeast direction, we have 3. north-northeast. So 3.4, 0.75 and 0. Like that, we have to go on writing for all of them. So this will indicate what? The duration of wind velocities, right? Duration of wind velocities. Now, once this is done, what we have to do is take transparent rectangular template or a paper strip. So let me write here. Transparent, right? So this strip is taken and is kept like this. You can observe, right? This length should be slightly greater than the outer diameter of the windrose diagram. And its width should be greater than twice the allowable crosswind component. Okay. So twice allowable crosswind component should be the width, very, very important. And the height should be more than the outer circle. So let me write width is equal to 2 times crosswind component and height is equal to greater than dia of outer circle, right? Then the scale of the crosswind component should be same as that of the concentric circles of the Rosewind diagram. Scale is a very important factor here. You have to choose the same scale. Okay. Along the center of the length of the template, a line is marked corresponding to the direction of the runway. So along the center, you have to mark the line. If you see, this dotted line will show you. So after that, two parallel lines on either side of the center line is drawn at a distance equal to the crosswind component. Okay. So from here, from the center, two lines will be drawn here and here. So in this case, the crosswind component is 25. So 2 into 25, this would be the width, right? So on two directions, 25 and 25 crosswind component distance, two lines will be marked to the scale. In other words, the two parallel lines of 50 kmph away from each other. Then after that, what we do is the windrose diagram is fixed in position on a drawing board, right? Then a hole is drilled in the center of the template and it is placed on the windrose diagram such that the center lies over the center of the rosewind diagram. In this position, the template is fixed by a pin passing through the center so that the template can be rotated about its axis. Right. Once we pin it, so basically what we do in the step 5, we just pin the rosewind diagram. Right. After that, the template is rotated and is placed along a particular direction. So in this position of the template, the duration of 6 to 25, 25 to 50 and 50 to 80 kmph winds are read for the radial directions lying between the two extreme parallel lines. So between two extreme parallel lines, this values will be read out. Okay. Sum of all these durations is expressed as the percentage and it will give the total wind coverage for that direction. Like in this particular case, for north, we have to add all of this, this and this, and then this and this with all of this. So that will give you what? Total wind coverage for that direction. Similarly, you have to do it for all other directions. Okay, all other directions. Now, finally, the direction which will give you the maximum wind coverage is a suitable direction for the orientation of the runway. Okay, so that is how you will decide in case of the windrose diagram, which is showing duration, direction, as well as the intensity. And as I told you, this is the most important one which they will choose for the determination of your runway orientation. Hope this is clear to you now. Thank you.